Have you ever wondered what it's like to be an MLB content producer? Well, in this video, I'm gonna show y'all. I want the top.
Welcome to season 4 of the vlog. Isn't it crazy that we're here right now?
Welcome back, everyone.
Don't trust me. If you don't want to do
this. I see you're still doing your little vlogging thing. That's really cute.
Welcome back to the channel, everyone. My name is Pete Gottschalk, content producer for Major League Baseball, and today I have a vlog for you. I've not vlogged in forever. I need to vlog more. It's been a long time since we vlogged, so I figured why not a better way to pick it back up with a little day in the life. I haven't done one of these in over a year. For the new viewers, this is for y'all. You can go watch that one. My setup has kind of changed, my voice cracked there, since that last year. You guys know that if you've watched my videos, but I'm going to take you guys first through my gear setup. I've been through it before. It kind of changes from month to month, but I'm gonna take y'all through it right now. So in this Pelican case, this is the important stuff. We have a Canon 7200 in here. We have a, I believe that's 16 to 35. And then we have three batteries. This lens cap that's actually for this camera. And then we have a Canon C70 with a 24 to 70 on it. Some gaff tape just in case. Oh, there's also a lav mic in here. For telephoto, this big Canon 200 to 400, you guys know I love this lens. On the C70, I actually have a speed booster, so that is normally a F4, but I can go down to F2.8 with what I have on it. So this is my laptop slash camera bag. This is where I put my Sony, what is what you're watching this on now. I have a trash bag just in case for if it rains. I have two hard drives here. I'm kind of running out of space. This right here is the handle to the Canon C70. I didn't want to waste tape, so I don't have this part yet that holds the Sennheiser for this camera. So I've just been taping it on and I didn't want to waste tape. I've been keeping it in here because it's the only place it'll fit. iPhone charger, I put my laptop charger in there too. We have a Metabones. We have a Sony E-mount to Canon EF. And then we also have this DJI Ronin S2. So that's what we take. We also have monopod, sorry. Monopod is probably the most important things would be the card reader, Lightning. Card reader to SD, cards, batteries, camera, obviously. Monopod is also very important. If I forgot that, I wouldn't be able to shoot at all. So those are the most important things. You guys have heard this spiel before, so I'm gonna get over to the stadium. I'm running a little behind schedule, actually. So let's get over to the stadium. It's time to shoot some BP. 24 holes in a hotel tower. 24 bitches on a guest list, yeah. 24 carats on my necklace, yeah. This is the setup we are rocking with for BP in most days. I might put the 16 to 35 on right here. These are my preferred cards. This is a Sony Tough, pretty durable, fast. That's all you need, really. But we do have a special guest. It's been a while since he's been on the vlog, and he has something funny. He has a funny story from last night. I didn't witness it, but I kind of did. Matthew's actually working for the Braves today. He's filling in for Kevin. So Matthew's just like, the light version of Kevin. Award-winning photographer. But Matthew, will you tell him what happened last night?
I gotta hide my identity. Last night, it was a walk-off. Fun, awesome, and since Kevin's not here, I'm filling in. I get to run up there with the players and get all the photos of them screaming, throwing water and everything. And I kind of wiped out. And I ran out there like way too fast, and I couldn't stop running, and then I bumped into people and start backpedaling, and then go, whoop. No, best case scenario, I got my shots, I got my viral moment, so.
So what we look for during BP is just kind of an array of things. Obviously guys hitting, fielding, just generally warming up for the game. I'm definitely gonna get copyrighted for this music out here, but it's pretty chill environment. I shoot it every day. So like, you gotta look for ways to like mix it up every once in a while. Whether that be shooting tighter or wider or shooting photos sometimes. That's what I've been doing a lot recently, just to kind of improve my photo game because I'm really not very good at it. And doing a lot of B-roll, just kind of for player edits, things like that, archival stuff. Because shooting guys, same guys hitting BP every day gets really, really repetitive. Right here is where I shoot the games from most of the time. I've been over this before in vlogs. That's home plate over there. Put the 200-400 on that and you get a good view. Sometimes I go in that inside well, which is like right to the right of that fence. I'll show an angle from there right now. I like that angle too. You feel like you're way more into action. This first base well is where we spend most of our time just because you get the reactions of the players right as they hit the ball. And obviously any left-handed pitcher too, you can get that as well.
Look at that. Braves mentioning Grimes.
All because he tripped.
Any publicity, good publicity.
So you guys just watched me photograph Giants BP. Like I said, I like to mix it up. I put that little, this kind of GoPro phone mount on top. And I really liked it, it was a cool perspective. Great for TikTok, great for things like that. So I hope you guys enjoyed that. I don't take photos all that much. My role is kind of live content producer now, so like, it's not limited to just video. And I feel like the Giants are gonna use more of my pregame photos. Just today, it's kind of a need-based thing. And I also like doing it. It's an area I need to improve in, and I don't have much experience in. So like, you know, it's just cool to kind of mix it up a little bit. You guys have seen me take a million BP videos, so why not do some photo? That perspective is cool. Anyway, I'm really craving a Chick-fil-A sandwich, so I'm gonna go up to the Infinity Club, grab that, and then it's game time. And that is it, folks. Giants won 12-10. It was a very entertaining game. A lot happened. Got a lot of good shots. Ronald hit a home run, which is always makes for a great shot. But overall, pretty successful day. Felt like I shot all right today. I shot a lot from up high, like 10 rows up. I don't know if you can see that up there. There's a little concourse. I used to shoot there a lot during the COVID year. But today, I decided to mix it up. I haven't shot a lot up there. And they had a bunch of broadcast cameras, as TBS normally does. So what's up, y'all? I'm back in my apartment. Showered, everything. It was a really long day of work. I was gonna end the vlog there, but I just had one more thing to say, and it's what I do post-game. I'm not gonna go deeply into my labeling process. I have a whole video on that. But basically, you can see I dragged one card in here already. I'm about to drag the other. These are the clips from today. Scroll down, grab them all, drop them in. About 16 gigs on that card, and I think it was 19 on the last one. It's not really a ton of footage. It depends on what I do and what I shoot in. If I'm in slow motion for a majority of the game or a couple innings, I'll shoot a little more. But I have pre-record on, which if you don't know what pre-record is, it basically only records 3 seconds before you hit record. So it's perfect for baseball. Well, no, sorry. Let me restate that. It starts recording 3 seconds before you hit record. So essentially you only hit record if there's like an impact on the bat or a good play. And it saves you a lot of card space, and it limits the amount of clips you gotta go through. I highly suggest that if you have a camera that is capable of it. This is the structure I use for clips and folders, 22, 06, 21, which is 2022, June 21st. Here is an example of a pre-labeled game. You can see, obviously, I have the folder labeled the same way, May 28th, 2022. If you want a better understanding of that process, I have a video on it. It's the Adobe Bridge video. Go look through my channel and go watch that one. But anyway, thank y'all for watching this video, and I'll see y'all in the next one.